hospitality. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce a lady who moves all around Corpus Christi like the wind, the Honorable Mayor Paulette Guajardo. Did she escape? There she is.
Thank you. You can take that, yeah. That was a beautiful introduction. Thank you, Bob. I'm so grateful and I'm humbled by your enduring friendship and support. Good afternoon. Welcome to the 2022 State of the City Address. Thank you for joining me today and celebrating our beautiful city. I would like to first thank John LaRue and Christy Toupet with the United Corpus Christi Chamber and the entire staff here at the American Bank Center. We also want to thank Mystic Entertainment, Zarin Gonzalez, and his crew for always providing an outstanding ambiance. I hope you're enjoying the very new, best of the brand new American Bank Center operations. I also would like to thank especially the City of Corpus Christi multimedia team and my staff for their efforts today. Today we stand on shoulders of great giants, and it is my distinct pleasure to welcome former Corpus Christi mayors, Mayor Joe Adami, Mayor Nelda Martinez, and Mayor Joe McComb. There is another mayor for whom we are deeply indebted, a visionary and a collaborative leader, Mayor Lloyd Neal, who served, yes. He served four terms as mayor of Corpus Christi and was elected county judge. Today, we offer our love and condolences to his beloved wife, Thetis, and his family. Judge Neal led countless instrumental projects, including the vision of building the new Harbor Bridge and Whataburger Field. Judge Neal was also the very first chair of the Corpus Christi Regional Economic Development Corporation. He was a man of great integrity, a military veteran, and therefore I've asked staff to lower the city flag in his honor. Gig 'em forever, Judge Lloyd Neal. I would also like to recognize my husband, Victor, and my son, Jude, as well as my parents, Juan and Magdalena Rodriguez, my sisters, Amy Mellish and Jessica Rodriguez. Thank you for your unwavering support through these years. Thank you. Teamwork and collaboration are the hallmarks of success. So please join me in recognizing the team that I have the great honor of working alongside, your dedicated City Council members. Councilman, will you please rise and be recognized as I call your name? Councilman Michael Hunter. John Martinez. Billy Lerma. Greg Smith. Ben Molina, Roland Barrera, Gil Hernandez, and Councilman Mike Pusley, who had a family obligation today, was not able to be with us today, but we applaud him as well. Thank you, gentlemen. We appreciate your service to our community. City Manager Peter Zanoni, will you please rise and be acknowledged? As mayor, one of my most important responsibilities is to provide oversight of the city's $1.4 billion budget. I am proud to report to you that we are in a new and unprecedented era of progress for Corpus Christi's future. At the City of Corpus Christi, we are 3,900 employees strong. Together with our City Council and City Manager, we will continue to work towards the prosperity of our city. Recently, the Austin American Statesman named one city they said is the most promising. And I quote, right now, the most exciting city in Texas is Corpus Christi. And that is because we have emerged as a city whose future is bright. So now let's get down to business. Across every department, the city of Corpus Christi is moving forward. For fiscal year 21-22, we developed a robust $1.4 billion budget with no city property tax rate increase. And as we continue with citizen engagement, this month we are conducting 5 scheduled community meetings in each council district because our city council believes that your voice matters. And in November, you will have the opportunity to vote on the second largest bond in our city's history, a $125 million bond program. And it's important to emphasize that this too will come with no city property tax rate increase. Included in the bond program are 32 projects that include investments in our streets, our parks, our public safety, and our library. And I would like to highlight that 74%, or $92.5 million, will be allocated to streets. $20 million will be allocated for parks, $10 million for public safety, and $2.5 million for library at the La Retama Library. The City Council also continues to challenge staff to cut waste and provide for greater operational efficiencies. We continue to maintain a strong reserve fund of 20%, utilizing over $13 million from the excess of our general fund balance, putting it to work for you towards maintenance and improvements around the city. In the oversight of Bond 2020, 100% of the projects are under construction or design. General fund first and second quarter revenues exceeded budgeted amounts, and expenditures were below budget. And it is significant to mention that during these economically challenging times, the City of Corpus Christi upheld our credit rating from the 3 credit rating agencies. Our general obligation debt and utility debt are considered high grade, and this is important because this keeps interest rates low, and that therefore saves taxpayer dollars. Also noteworthy is that the city's credit rating has increased 3 times since City Manager Peter Zanoni was appointed by the council in 2019. In the fiscal year 2021 comprehensive annual financial report by external auditors, the report gave the city the highest audit opinion that can be issued. I want to also recognize our Chief Financial Officer, Constance Sanchez, for her budget acumen and for her over 30 years of service to Corpus Christi. So today I stand before you to report that the state of our city budget and finance is strong. All of this has been accomplished by the teamwork that is propelling our success. Our team understands that we are here to serve you. In the City of Corpus Christi, we believe in the values of faith, family, and community. We thank those who serve our country and work to preserve our great democracy. We are a military city with a proud legacy to this entire nation. And you've heard me say, and I will continue saying, that Corpus Christi will take its rightful place among the great cities of Texas with our unrivaled natural resources and our breathtaking bayfronts and beaches. And as we are acutely aware of our opportunities, we are also aware of our city's great challenges, and we know that we have a significant amount of work in front of us. For far too long, the City of Corpus Christi delayed maintenance, and our streets and parks fell into disrepair. We will not go back to those days. We will move forward to continue to rebuild, to repair, and to refocus our priorities to build upon our successes. So please join me now for a short video on economic development.
Thank you. working to create a greater future for Corpus Christi. And moving forward, our economy takes a city that works for small businesses, understands the needs of industry, and promotes business development.
Economic development is a very exciting topic for us here in Corpus Christi. The word is getting out in the state that Corpus Christi is the place to be. I've had numerous companies tell me they hear this statewide. And not only do we hear it, we see it. And so companies are setting up headquarters here in Corpus Christi. We have more small businesses that are relocating here or opening business here in Corpus Christi. That's because of the tremendous momentum forward that the mayor and city council have caused for this great city and businesses here that across the state.
We are starting to grow. We're starting to grow. I know that having these large places, you know, are bringing jobs, but we're growing through other parts. And other parts are tech or entrepreneur. These are the things that we need in the quality of place to bring these here and to make sure that our workforce is trained to get those jobs. The EDC sees a great future for Corpus Christi.
Creating a vibrant downtown is a key economic development strategy for our region. It will create strong quality of life, help cultivate community pride, and attract visitors to our idyllic waterfront. With the support of the mayor and strong community partnerships, we kicked off a summer focused on the arts. We were able to commission 6 large-scale murals featuring both local and national artists to add to our vibrant downtown scene. With the support of the mayor, city council, and city manager, we'll continue to facilitate new projects. Some wonderful projects that you'll see this year include Hype Bike, The Annex, a new wine bar, and Retrocade in the downtown area. All of this wonderful activity is only possible through our strong community partnerships and the unprecedented level of support we're currently receiving from the mayor, city council, and city leadership.
I'm very proud of the people of Corpus Christi that work every single day for progress, from the revitalization of downtown to rebuilding of the Cole Park Pier to reconstruction of Air Street and regional growth and development. The city of Corpus Christi is your partner for progress.
That was a great, great video. So paramount to our economic development and moving forward, our economy is fixing our streets. You will hear me say many times that fixing our streets is one of my highest priorities, and I understand that it is the highest priority of our residents. Fixing our streets is going to take many years, and this is why we are making an unprecedented investment in our future. Over the past 3 years, the city has invested $325 million for street maintenance and reconstruction. We are making progress, and I am pleased to report that there are 36 construction projects underway throughout the city as I speak. One of our signature projects, Ocean Drive, a $10.5 million reconstruction project, was completed this past May. Ocean Drive had not been repaired in 48 years, and today we celebrate the most scenic corridor in our city finally repaired. Citywide, from our residential streets to our major arteries, we are proactively addressing infrastructure, from Air Street to Everhart Road, to Rodfield Road to Airline Road, to Laguna Shores Boulevard. We are making real progress that is visible from every corner of the city. And as we focus on infrastructure, the City Council is committing $4.7 million in financial assistance from the Clean Water State Revolving Fund to address the severe flooding of the Oso Creek. We've also allocated $5 million from federal stimulus funding to address citywide drainage issues comprehensively. In providing better service to you, we've just announced the enactment of the 311 Customer Call Center. This is a $2.2 million investment in technology that will provide you information, address issues, and reduce any non-emergency calls with unparalleled agility. And in furthering our service to you, we must also understand the conditions that affect our residents and our economy. As you all know, our city is in stage 1 of drought conditions. This is something our city council takes very seriously, and there is nothing more important to me today than securing a long-term water source. For over 129 years, the City of Corpus Christi has been the water provider, and it is our responsibility to plan and distribute our water supply to meet projected growth. We fully understand our critical role as the area water producer. And I want you to hear it directly from me. I am laser focused on building seawater desalination for our future. As the water producer, distributor, and planner of this region, the city is undertaking the development of an uninterruptible water source in desalination. The city has permits in process, funding in the form of a low-interest loan from the Texas Water Development Board in an amount of $222 million. And we are also in the process of land acquisition. Only the City of Corpus Christi has the customers and the water infrastructure necessary to bring seawater desalination online to provide the lowest cost water for our ratepayers. And it is important for you to know that we serve over 500,000 people in seven counties, including Nueces, San Patricio, Aransas, Clayburgh, Bee, Jim Wells, and Live Oak. And in the operations of our water utility department, the city builds and owns our water lines. Since 2017, we've invested over $135 million to replace aging infrastructure. We also have a proposed capital improvement program that includes a long-range water supply investment of over $174 million. This funding is to provide water desalination, upgrades to the water plant, and significant investment in our water distribution system. And this is why it makes me exceptionally proud to share that our water system is rated superior by the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality. Our city team is working hard every single day, and they recognize that success will be determined by those who plan, execute, and mobilize quickly. And in acknowledging the progress we are making in critical infrastructure and service to you, I want to recognize our team is led by a world-class city manager in Peter Zanoni. Peter continues to ensure a high level of performance. And Peter, I want to thank you and your executive team because we are moving forward a transformational city in government. Ladies and gentlemen, the state of the city's infrastructure is strong and getting stronger. Every day we work to promote our economy, to create great jobs, and to support small business. The City of Corpus Christi is the principal investor in the Corpus Christi Regional Economic Development Corporation. This budget cycle, the City Council is investing in an economic development department to provide a strategic framework to assist small business and work collaboratively with the CCREDC. The city is also the leader in providing for area growth through the development of infrastructure. This is the key component that allows our region to land major industries. One of those industries is Steel Dynamics, that came online this year with a $3 billion capital investment and 590 jobs. In concurrence, there are 27 projects associated with Steel Dynamics. At the conclusion of our individual agreements with our partners, Cheniere, ArcelorMittal Texas, HBI, and Gulf Coast Growth Ventures, they will enter into the City of Corpus Christi's Industrial District. At this juncture, the city will have yielded over $147 million in net property taxes over 10 years and over $800 million over 20 years. And hold on, because there are more projects in the pipeline, pun intended. The CCREDC has ushered in $1.1 billion in new projects, 433 jobs, and over $25 million in new wages in this fiscal year alone. It is the City of Corpus Christi's economic development and key infrastructure investments, along with enduring area partnerships, that is vaulting our economy. Thank you to our regional mayors and elected officials that are committed to moving forward together our progress. Next year will be another legislative session. And as Region 11 Texas Municipal League President, I am working cooperatively to develop public policy that benefits our area. And over the past century, our city's most important investment, the Port of Corpus Christi, has exceeded the demands of maritime commerce, with President Biden's proposed funding of $157 million. The Corpus Christi Ship Channel Improvement Project will finally be slated for completion. The Port of Corpus Christi is the largest gateway for U.S. energy exports and the third largest seaport in the nation in total water tonnage. Together with the city's infrastructure investments, the port and the city have been instrumental in generating 90,000 plus jobs for our region. And also in moving forward job creation, this year the city welcomed James Avery Craftsman Manufacturing. With their acquisition of a 41,000 square foot building, James Avery will add 200 plus jobs to our economy. This is a great example of how we are working to diversify our workforce. And reporting on the progress of our improvements districts, the City Council recently approved Whitecap Public Improvement District number 1 to move forward a nearly $1 billion master planned community on Padre Island that will include residential, retail, and entertainment. This is an extraordinary example on how the city is harnessing capital and building our competitive edge. In other economic development investments, we continue to fund important projects in North Beach. Our most recent investment consists of 3 development incentive agreements approved by the Tax Increment Reinvestment Zone, totaling an estimated $3 million. In addition, and as a result of Bond 2020, we have great amenities planned for Surfside Park, also located in North Beach. And down the road, our Texas State Aquarium, with an over $20 million city contribution since its inception, continues to be a world-class city asset that we are very proud of. Next spring, we will celebrate the grand opening of a $16 million wildlife rescue center. The future of North Beach has never looked so promising. Great American cities that leverage opportunities for their economies also critically focus on reimagining their downtowns. Corpus Christi is the 8th largest city in Texas, and taking our rightful place among the great cities means working to build a greater downtown. The Downtown Management District, led by Alyssa Barrera Mason, is spearheading revitalization efforts with landmark funding of nearly $80 million. This funding is designed to leverage incentives to attract private sector investment, with many projects forthcoming. And we're also creating a new wave of beautification, from world-class murals to lighting 100 trees to flowers on every corner, building a new dynamic ambiance. We are transforming downtown every single day. We've also made a monumental investment in our marina, and to catapult our progress, seawall funds, initially debt financed, have been given the opportunity over the last 2 years to provide flood protection along the seawall, the breakwater, and the marina. All of this is designed to comprehensively revitalize and renew 4 key areas: our downtown, our seawall, our marina, and our T heads. This is part of my vision for Corpus Christi's future. In propelling our future, we've also made a significant investment through our Taipei Fund. Since 2002, the fund has garnered an estimated $390 million. This is a phenomenal reinvestment in our city that attracts and retains businesses. Please join me now in watching a short video on our City Council's United Team progress.
In the city of Corpus Christi, there is a new spirit of progress. Under the leadership of Mayor Paulette Guajardo and the members of the City Council, there is a renewed spirit of teamwork.
City leadership is the ultimate catalyst for action. It provides the governance to act on strategic priorities for the future of this city. We are driving dynamic success through the modernization of our technology, the rebuilding of infrastructure, and the outreach to all of our residents.
City leadership is important for us so that we can focus on the things that are important and the things that will help this community grow, to help us provide jobs, to help us provide the quality of life things that people need to enjoy life when they're not working.
We need to work together and have common goals so that we can move forward and make Corpus Christi a better place.
For us to be united in our decisions shows a sign of strength, not only to the citizens, but also to the surrounding areas and to the state.
Across the city, residents can finally see progress from the addition of more police and firefighters, to street repair, to the rebuilding of the iconic Cole Park Pier.
We have so much opportunity in Corpus in so many ways. We have it in our economy, new industry, new jobs coming in. We have great changes on the island. Downtown, we're starting a revitalization of downtown.
Talking to the community, finding out what it is that's important to them, talking to the business leaders in this community, talking to the people that invest in this community, taking that leadership and putting the package together and preparing a vision.
City Council is working together to improve our city by distinguishing funds equally amongst each district for an upcoming bond project. It's also working on certain citywide projects like your fire, police, utilities.
Promoting innovation with a strategy approach and a keen eye to the future.
When I see us in 5 years, I want to make sure that we're 5, 10, 15 years down the road, is that we're in a much better place with just the regular infrastructure of the city, so we can do greater things.
We've got a great start on the growth of Corpus Christi and the prosperity of Corpus Christi. We've got projects all over this city, that from the island to Annabelle Cal Allen, to Labonte Park, to North Beach, to the South Sides. If you just go and look at your city, you're going to see all kinds of projects, all kinds of development.
Corpus Christi is a city of momentum, taking bold steps, tackling our biggest challenges with leadership that is united for progress.
The City Council collaborates to achieve our success. It is fundamental to successful municipal government that we seek a unified voice for progress. We are collaborative, service-oriented, and we share a collective vision of progress for Corpus Christi.
Thank you. We also understand that a renewed focus on our airport is crucial to our long-term economic development goals. In an effort to secure airline incentives, this past April, our airport director called me about a grant opportunity that the federal government was offering. The grant was to help communities expand air service, and this particular grant required a community match. I immediately picked up the phone and made some calls. Today, I have a surprise announcement. The City of Corpus Christi is the proud recipient of an air service development grant of $750,000 from the U.S. Department of Transportation. We will use these funds specifically to help us secure nonstop flights to Denver and Las Vegas.
Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas!
That was a little delayed, sorry. It was supposed to be perfect. Okay. So for this, I would like to thank Eric Evans with Corpus Christi Medical Center, Kevin Lasson with Valero Energy for saying yes without hesitation. Now that we've secured this grant, we will need to raise an additional $150,000 for the community match. So there is still opportunity for everyone in this room to become a part of this great initiative. This City Council had a significant focus on our airport approving a first ever incentive program. This program will help us land new routes to various destinations. And a big thank you to Kevin Smith, Director of Aviation, and his team for their leadership in building greater opportunities for our airport. I am happy to report that the state of our regional relationships and economic development is strong. Over the course of my service to you, you've continually heard me prioritize public safety. I believe that keeping our residents safe is my highest calling. My critical focus as a council member and as mayor has been in supporting our police and fire departments. I want you to know that the entire City Council joins me in this sentiment. In Corpus Christi, we support our police and firefighters, and I want you to hear directly from me that I do back the blue. Last month, I issued a call to action, a critical challenge to City Manager Peter Zanoni and the Crime Control District Board to find the funding to hire a total of 25 police officers. This is five times more than originally proposed, and it will bring our total of police sworn officers to 491. This will be the largest number of hired officers in the history of the city of Corpus Christi. This past March, our police academy graduated 41 cadets, which also made it the largest police academy class in the history of the Corpus Christi Police Department. And as we're making history in hiring, we are also moving forward a new academy training facility that will boast state-of-the-art police training technologies. The design for the new academy, located at the Del Mar College Oso Creek campus, is 90% complete. The project itself is expected to begin construction this fall. All of these efforts are focused on building the safety of our community. I want to thank Chief Mike Markle for his exemplary service and inspirational leadership. And if you, yes. If you are a member of the Corpus Christi Police Department, please rise so that we can extend to you our sincere thanks. Our City Council is also making investments to strengthen our Corpus Christi Fire Department. Our fire department is 464 firefighters strong, and for the first time in decades, they have achieved full staffing. In large part, this is due to the civilian to paramedic pilot program, in which a firefighter is trained simultaneously as a paramedic. The pilot program has proven to be a model for the state of Texas and the nation. We are proud that our team is part of the innovative trends of the future. And I am also excited to share with you that Fire Station Number 3 on Morgan Avenue, one of the busiest in the nation, will have its groundbreaking this fall, boasting the latest in fire station technology and design. Additionally, our hazmat team earned the FEMA Type 1 designation, making them only one of three fire departments to receive this status in the entire state of Texas. For all of these accomplishments, I wish to extend my sincere thanks to Fire Chief Robert Rocha for their hard work and your accomplishments. Thank you. If you are a member of the Corpus Christi Fire Department, please rise so that we can extend our sincere thanks to you as well. Another component of public safety is ensuring that we have a strong emergency management operation. Under state law, the mayor of the city of Corpus Christi is the emergency operations manager, and I take that role very seriously. The strong ability to respond to a crisis is vital to the resiliency of a community. Our emergency operations center is the hub for all coordination of the city's emergency planning, training, response and recovery efforts. Our emergency operations team provides multiple platforms to share information and data with the public. In the event of an emergency or when disaster strikes, We will operate under the nationally recognized incident management system so that procedures outlined in our emergency preparedness plan are executed, because preparedness is paramount to disaster resiliency. And due to these extraordinary efforts, the state of our city's public safety is strong. Please join me now for our next video on public safety.
First responders are the backbone of this city, and we truly believe that. This council holds public safety paramount, and we're going to continue to do that because they have to have the tools they need to protect the residents, the families, the children of this city, and that's what we plan to continue to do.
Under this mayor and city council, the Corpus Christi Fire Department, for the first time in decades, has achieved full staffing, meaning all of our fire trucks and all of our ambulances have enough personnel to operate on a day-to-day basis.
This council and mayor have pushed for diversion and crisis intervention for the last few years, as have we. They've recognized the need for it, and yeah, they're all in. They're all in for a better community. That's indicative of a good leadership, in my opinion. Just this last year, we've added 10 additional officers over attrition, bringing our funded staff currently up to 466.
By having enough firefighters to do the job, what it allows us to do is it allows firefighters to be able to execute, perform, and do well in their day-to-day operations. The direct impact for public safety for the fire department is that we're able to provide a high level of service to our public. We're able to get to a fire scene in an expedited manner.
Over the last decade or more that we've transitioned, or we are still transitioning, from a crime fighter mentality to a problem solving mentality. Working on homeless, working on mental health issues, working with our veterans, back to school initiatives, safety initiatives, preemptive initiatives that keep people safe before the police are needed.
The members of the fire department are able to see the support that we're receiving from the mayor and council when it comes to purchases that we're able to execute, that we're able to buy equipment for the fire department, that we're able to hire personnel, that we're able to graduate fire cadets from academy and put them out in the field to make our fire department better.
We've also built a new substation in Flower Bluff. That would be the first one. There's more to come in the next few years, but it's going to be a full service substation where it's going to be manned by or staffed with full-time personnel. That, you know, we worked through pandemic, we worked through a whole lot of issues. It's taken a holistic approach, a whole lot of different departments, a whole lot of folks in the community, and it really pays off that we've built long-lasting relationships.
Every great American city has a vibrant parks and library system. Parks are extremely important to our residents and to our city council. Our team is working harder than ever to maintain and build our park system. This year, the city of Corpus Christi rebuilt and reopened our iconic Cole Park Pier. Cole Park Pier is integrated into the fabric of our community and our city's rich culture. Built in the 1930s, Cole Park Pier is a city landmark, from live music at the amphitheater to celebrating birthdays or catching your first fish. Cole Park Pier is a generational landmark. Another exciting project was the reopening of Dimmitt Pier, located in Flower Bluff. With better lighting, breakwater, and parking lot improvements, this pier will also be enjoyed for years to come. Continuing our commitment to augment parks, we recently installed 11 playground units to include Los Encinos, Senior Officer Juan Prieto, San Diego, Eastley, Carroll Lane, Austin, Stonegate, Sergeant J.D. Bach, Camargo, Lakeview, and Winrock Parks. With the future of our parks in consideration, we've established a long-range planning effort. As part of the overall vision, we recently completed a 10-year Parks, Recreation, and Open Space Master Plan. We're also taking a critical step in the creation of master plans for three of our signature city parks that are all staples in our community, Labonte Park, Cole Park, and Bill Witt Park. We are reimagining each of these green spaces to an unparalleled level. And moving on to libraries, I invite you to visit one of your local public libraries. In this digital age, these learning centers are they're vital in helping our residents and visitors gain access to computers, improve their skill sets, apply for jobs, and of course, promote literacy. I'm proud to say that our Bond 2022 Bond Program includes proposed funding for much needed improvements at our beloved La Retama Library. And as we look back on 2021, one of our greatest milestones was the unanimous vote of the City Council, which included the support of the Nueces County Commissioners to approve the transition of the City County Health Department, which was at the time co-governed. It is now an exclusively city-run public health district. This endeavor entailed implementing a new and modern business model, which will garner improved health outcomes, having a more efficient utilization of taxpayer dollars, and provide a positive work environment for all employees. Our new health district was relaunched, and a critical first step was to reopen our health clinic so that a comprehensive list of services could be reinstated. Of equal importance was adding a multitude of programs to benefit some of our city's most vulnerable population. Ladies and gentlemen, we are tackling a transformational effort. It is unprecedented. We have an enormous task before us, and our team remains focused and committed. We are building a path forward to achieve the fundamental promise that we have made to you. I consider my public service to be a sacred pact between myself and the people of Corpus Christi. We will fulfill our promise to all of our stakeholders, especially our children. And we will work every day to leave them a city where they can build a more brilliant and sustainable future, because our future is never looking brighter than now. History tells us that Corpus Christi is the only city in the United States named after the body of Christ. Today, as we move forward in faith and with the support of the people of Corpus Christi, that means so much. I stand before you as your mayor to tell you that the state of our city is strong, and it is a new day in Corpus Christi. And together, we will do it united, and know that this has all only just begun. Thank you, and God bless.